Hi, welcome to the Shtick. This episode starts with the Jewish Taskforce Against Family Violence morning tea, featuring Natasha Stott Despoja as the keynote speaker, ending with the opening of the Andy Warhol Jewish Geniuses at the Jewish Museum of Australia. That's all you're going to get this week. I hope you enjoy the show. No interviews, no extras. I hope you have a really good time watching it.
My name is Debbie Wiener. I am the chair of the Jewish Task Force Against Family Violence. It is my great pleasure to welcome you all here today to sell our house, thank you, to what promises to be a stimulating and exciting morning.
Today we have some panellists who will be speaking to you. Each of them has an extraordinary level of knowledge concerning these matters and a high level of involvement in trying to deal with the kinds of issues to which I've referred. The first of them, of course, is Professor Carolyn Taylor. Now, Carolyn Taylor is a very interesting and a very complicated person in a number of senses. Carolyn was herself a victim of very serious assault as a child. She left school initially at 9, not by choice, but ultimately managed to overcome those enormous hurdles that were in front of her, has gained her doctorate of philosophy, and is now both a powerful academic and a powerful advocate for victims' rights. There is probably no one better qualified to look at these issues from that academic, understanding perspective, and a person who really has lived the experiences about which she speaks. Natasha Stott Despoja is, of course, an extremely well-known person in our political scene. I remember, and I don't want to sound sexist about it, but when she first went into Parliament, I thought, God, I wish all the Pollies looked like her. Sorry, David. But Natasha Stott Despoja is a highly intelligent, dedicated woman who has made an incredible contribution to our society in a wide variety of areas, including this. She is an ambassador in this area, and of course, as the foundation chair of the Foundation to Prevent Violence Against Women and Children. It is a privilege to be able to introduce Natasha Stott Despoja to you. Finally, of course, there is Bernie Geary, the Children's Commissioner for the State of Victoria. I've known Bernie Geary since we were both relatively young people, not that we're not relatively young people now, but for a very, very long time. And Bernie has been involved in the looking after the interests of children, and particularly disadvantaged children, for the whole of his adult life. He has insights both at the practical working level of a youth worker, right up to the development of organisational policies and government policies in this particular area. So each of these people can make a very considerable contribution and is making a very considerable contribution to our society, and each of them has a perspective which I'm sure you will find interesting. Thank you.
I feel as though my heart is being held out to you in my hands. I'm holding it out to you so that the darkness of child abuse may be seen in undiluted light. and that is why I do it. Some of what I will touch upon may upset you and may be extremely personal. I'm sharing something very personal. I hope I don't offend or upset, but at the end of the day, this was my life, and I've chosen to share aspects of that. And I speak because it is in the humble hope that by breaking a silence that had to be overcome, it allows our songs of experience to show you why a caged bird still sings. For I am she with the broken wing.
But of course, I particularly acknowledge the bravery and inspiration that is Professor Caroline here today. We are sorry for your loss. We acknowledge your loss. And the horror with which you have confronted us this morning, because we are confronted and we are horrified, even though many of you, many of us who work in a variety of sectors and environments, know this happens, understand this happens, may have experienced this happening, but we're still horrified and confronted by it. But I hope today it's inspired all of us anew, or people for the first time, to act. As Frank said in his introductory comments, you know, we all have a responsibility to end this abuse. Today, on this Universal Day of the Child, I'd like to start with a video, if I may, which outlines some of the themes and the work of the organisation of which I chair Our Watch. So I'm hoping that someone has better technological skills than me will now press a button and it will appear.
When I grow up, my husband tells me what to do. When I grow up, my wife puts me first. I won't be seen or heard.
When I grow up, I want to tell her who to be friends with.
I'll beat my wife when she offends me.
When I grow up, I'm going to end up in hospital because my husband hit me.
This is the dream of no child ever.
1 in 6 Australian women have experienced physical or sexual violence from a current or former partner.
1 in 5 Australian women has experienced sexual violence.
That means each of us knows one of these women.
I know one of these women. Me.
No child enters this world dreaming of committing violence.
No man wakes up one morning and out of the blue murders his partner.
The long road to family violence starts with the belief that women are possessions, not equals.
Most men are not violent, but the vast majority of acts of domestic and sexual violence are perpetrated by men against women.
Our beliefs about the way boys and girls, women and men are supposed to act are formed in childhood.
Around the world, gender stereotypes and unequal power between men and women are the most important underlying causes of family violence.
We can stop this before it starts.
By saying no to attitudes, stereotypes and behaviours that support gender inequality and violence.
We can help boys create more positive and healthier ways of being men.